Welcome to Rajya Sabha TV. You're watching our special show on Parliamentary Standing Committee. I'm Amritanshu Rai. In this show, we bring to you in-depth coverage of reports of the Standing Committee on the functioning of ministries and their departments. Today, we'll tell you about the report of the Standing Committee on Ministry of External Affairs on the piracy bill. The Standing Committee on Ministry of External Affairs has expressed concern over the rise of piracy along the western coast. The committee has pulled up the government for not being able to identify a nodal agency to deal with piracy issues.
The Standing Committee on External Affairs analyzed the activities of pirates on the Indian Ocean region in the last 10 years. The committee felt the absence of a specific anti-piracy law is restricting Indian authorities from capturing pirates' activities in the Arabian Sea. It asked the government to push through the legislation to ensure its speedy implementation. The report of the committee says that the Act will provide necessary legal framework to prosecute persons accused of piracy relating crimes in the territorial waters. The report says there should be a dedicated authority to handle issues relating to piracy to avoid any clash of jurisdiction amongst various ministries and state governments.
Piracy has been a very serious problem for the entire nation, and particularly for those states which have a sea line, say like Maharashtra, Bengal, or Andhra, or Trivandrum, Kerala, or Chennai. For them, it's a very serious issues, because many pirates, they take away the ships on shore.
From Vizag to, and then up with the big harbour is Visakhapatnam, and then Tamil Nadu, Chennai and Tuticorin ports are there, then Kerala, Cochin port is there, and then our Maharashtra and Orissa. These are all areas where we have to be looked at, like a lab. We are inland, the home affairs and all, we are very paka. But in the sea, coastal guard, we are lacking behind, sir. Because because of this, we need a domestic law. Yes. There's a definite domestic law to control the international piracy people, to control them.
Well, piracy has become a multi-billion dollar business today. We are quite certain that there is some kind of syndicates that are operating, and the persons who actually do the job are not the ones who are getting the full benefit or not getting the larger share of the ransom. That goes into something else.
The Standing Committee examined the provisions of the piracy bill and asked the government to make the Ministry of External Affairs the nodal agency for the implementation of the proposed law. The committee asked the Minister of Shipping to take proactive measures to ensure welfare of Indian seafarers who are captured by pirates on domestic vessels or on ships bearing foreign flags. The committee suggested the government should derive a mechanism on matters relating to regulation of ships sailing on high seas, providing insurance to ships and framing rules for ships bearing foreign flags. The committee pointed out that the piracy bill is silent on the issue of demarcating jurisdiction with regard to arrest, trial and prosecution of pirates and relating to evidence. The committee asked the Minister of Home Affairs to evolve a formula to decide jurisdiction of a particular state for acceptance of pirates captured in specific areas of exclusive economic zone. The Minister of Home Affairs should also identify prominent ports and coastal police stations for handing over of arrested pirates, and all this should be notified through an appropriate legal mechanism. The committee has also recommended effective communication, intelligence and information sharing among various ministries.
This problem, this piracy issue, should be taken as external affairs problem and also as national defense problem. These were the feelings of the most of the members.
We are keeping the piracy people, but we can't convict because of a lack of act. So whom has to come for the forward for this act, whether Home Department or External Affairs? So then only we come to arrival. So that must be a nodal agency, so External Affairs. That the External Affairs secretary came to the committee. He given a return. No, we won't take it. No, but the committee has decided they have to take it.
The committee was critical of the government for not consulting state governments while drafting the bill. It urged the government to take suggestions from state governments as they are the implementing agencies.
The committee has also asked the government to provide an interdepartmental coordination for better handling of piracy issues. To tell us more on the subject, I am joined by my colleague Raj Kamal Rao. Raj, what has the committee said on the appointment of officers?
Appointment of officers is crucial when you implement the piracy bill, because they have to deal with CRPC, IPC, and the bill itself involves several ministries, a Ministry of Home Affairs, Ministry of External Affairs, and they also have to deal with the state governments. So in this context, committee suggested to form a committee which can decide the appointment of officers who are capable of handling CRPC, IPC, as well as able to deal with the state governments and the jail authorities in states and across the coastal guards and other Indian Navy officials who are involved in curbing the activities of these pirates.
We spoke to Member of Standing Committee Mr. H.K. Dua and began by asking him the need for a separate legislation on piracy.
Over 108 pirates we have captured, our Navy has captured, in brave acts of... They are in Arthur Jail in Bombay. Our laws are there, I'm sure they're competent laws, but they're old, they want to update it. And the laws should have some conformity with the international law. So this bill was needed. Operations have to be carried on the seas by the Navy and by the Coast Guard. Coast Guard within territorial limits, in the economic zone, exclusive economic zone, it's this the Navy. And if our shipping is affected elsewhere beyond the territorial waters, the Navy is well prepared, as it was handling in Somalia, yes. Off the coast of Somalia, where the problem is more serious. They've done a good job. The Navy has done a good job. So this law will strengthen the powers of the Navy to deal with piracy. This law is also aimed at giving the trial of the pirates in a special law, rather than general Indian penal code, in a special law meant for piracy. This law will also help in giving them just trial. They have to be tried. If you capture, then they have to be tried in the courts. That's quite a bit of a problem. Then the states come into the picture. The committee raised this question, have you consulted the states? At the moment, most of the pirates which are captured brought to Bombay, because this problem is in the Arabian Sea. So that's why the Bombay High Court will have to try the cases. But supposing somebody has been captured off Cochin, or Bay of Bengal somewhere, there's no serious problem. So I think suggestions have been considered that there should be 4 designated high courts. Who has to designate the high courts? Supreme Court Chief Justice will be asked, requested to designate the high courts. And most probably it will be Bombay and Cochin and Vishakhapatnam or Calcutta, like that kind of things. But that's a matter of detail.
Your committee said External Affairs Ministry should be the nodal agency, even though in the meeting that you've written in your report, the witness meeting, they say they don't want to be the nodal agency. They've given a written reply, which is also part of the report presented. So what was the process involved in making them nodal agency? Was there any constitutional provision?
No, the reason being the prisoners belong to another country. Pirates. They belong to another country. Home Ministry can't deal with them. Defense can't deal with them. Navy has done its job by capturing them on the seas, whether exclusive economic zone or in the territorial waters, wherever they found the pirates were troubling them. And our Navy has done a good job. So has the Coast Guard. They've been vigilant about it. But its External Affairs Ministry has to deal with the problems of the foreign nationals. Now, there are diplomatic connotations. Then convention is, UN convention is also the UN law of the seas, which is the, that's also, law of the sea is also international matter.
Yes.
Now, so Ministry of External Affairs has to be the nodal agency, but prosecution will come under home.
Yes.
Capturing has to be done by the Navy, that means Ministry of Defense. So who is to, so they have to coordinate. Then shipping also comes. Supposing some Indian ship is involved.
Yes.
Where shipping ministry, ship is involved, which is victim of the piracy. then Ministry of Shipping is naturally, they are coordinating the movement of every merchant navy ship. Mm. So, but again, the ship will belong to some other country. Mm. Supposing some other country comes. Mm. The pirates certainly are foreigners.
Yes.
Then again, foreign affairs will come. Mm. So the nodal agency will be foreign affairs, mm. but it has to coordinate with the ministry.
Sir,
now, as far as prosecution is concerned, mm. who is to follow the pirates, mm. how they are being tried, mm. justice being administered, mm. trial, etc. That naturally Home Ministry will deal with them.
Okay.
Sir, Ministry of External Affairs can't be dealing with the Home Secretary of Maharashtra government or the High Court of that.
Yeah,
so,
sure.
that so there is a nodal agency, but each purpose again will have nodal functions. Ministry of Home Affairs will have to appoint officers. Mm. How many pirates are there in the jails? Whether how that tried? No, Navy which has captured the pirates, mm. they can't follow each case.
Exactly.
That will be the Home Ministry.
It's time for us to head into a break. When we return, we'll tell you about the committee's recommendations on death penalty. The Standing Committee has asked the government to review the provisions on death penalty. According to the report, death penalty provisions will create hurdles in extraditing criminals from foreign countries.
The Standing Committee report says the provision of death penalty in the bill must be reviewed in the light of international nature of crime. The report refers to several cases in the past where the government faced difficulties in extraditing criminals because of death penalty provided for in the law. The committee asked the government to change the title of the proposed bill to Anti-Maritime Piracy Bill instead of Piracy Bill to avoid any confusion.
See, when we say piracy, there are many things which come under the term called piracy. So committee was very specific that if we want to make the law effective, then it should, even the title should be very, very precise and pointed. Therefore, we suggested it should be called anti-maritime, because all the provisions in the bill, they deal with the piracy that happens in the sea.
So even the private shipping people are now afraid. Mm. Even to this shipping activities is now in India, it is going on decreasing because of these crimes over this.
Mm.
So for that only our committee is working to make a different laws and different amendments in the bills.
Mm.
On the issue of arrested pirates, the Standing Committee asked the government to appoint officers capable of handling complicated cases under the provisions of Criminal Procedure Code. Such officers must work in coordination with defence personnel. The committee also recommended inter-agency coordination for investigation, prosecution and providing evidence during the trial. It noted that there is a significant departure in the approach of the proposed law as it shifts the burden of proof on the accused. The report says the Ministry of Law and Justice must be consulted to avoid any conflict with the Criminal Procedure Code. It says at least one designated court must be identified in each coastal state to ensure speedy disposal of piracy cases.
MPs felt that this should not come in the purview of the states, Indian states, because this should be treated exactly as the national. But there was another thought that said that yes, once the center gives the nod, then the operating agency should be the state mechanism. So that I think that has prevailed.
Pirates have, as you know, have shifted their area of operations much closer to the Indian waters. So it is a major concern. There are I don't have the statistics with me, but a very large number of ships which are currently in the pirates' hands for about a year plus is the time that they have been holding them.
The committee is of the view that the proposed bill must include provisions for legal immunity for acts done in good faith, considering the nature of maritime piracy. It has asked the government to make all efforts to enhance international cooperation on issue of maritime piracy. The committee has also recommended that India must be part of all international endeavours to combat piracy. The Gulf of Aden and Somalia coast have witnessed a string of pirate attacks in the recent past. Some incidents have also happened in India's exclusive economic zone. The Navy and Coast Guard have succeeded in apprehending a number of Somali pirates who are now in the custody of Indian police. But without an effective legal framework, it is difficult for the judiciary to convict them. The government proposes a tough piracy bill to empower judiciary. The draft bill was proposed by the Cabinet on 24 January 2012 and the bill was introduced in the Lok Sabha on 24 April 2012.
The Standing Committee has asked the Ministry of External Affairs to consult the Law Ministry on the provision of shifting the burden of proof on the accused. To tell us more on the issue, I'm joined by my colleague Raj Kamal Rao. Raj, what does the committee feel about shifting the burden of proof on the accused?
See, in general, burden of proof is not shifted to accused. You will have other legal procedures to prove someone is guilty or not guilty. Here, the government is trying to shift the burden of proof onto the accused so that you can guess more accountability from the accused. But in this situation, the committee is suggesting the parliament and as well as the government to consult law ministry and take their cognizance and take their permission before including this amendment and before implementing this provision in the particular piracy bill.
We spoke to Mr. Inder Singh Namdhari, member Standing Committee on Ministry of External Affairs, and began by asking him on the provisions of death penalty.
देखिए ये पायरेसी बिल चूंकि अभी हमारे पास कोई डोमेस्टिक ऐसा लॉ नहीं है जिससे कि हम जो पायरेसी की घटनाएं होती हैं उन पर हम दूसरे देशों के लोगों को यहां पर बुला सकें उनको सज़ा दे सकें इसलिए इसकी बहुत आवश्यकता महसूस की गई और इसीलिए स्टैंडिंग कमेटी ने ये तय किया कि बिल बने इसके लिए पूरे प्रयास किए जाएँ लेकिन दिक्कत ये थी कि कोई भी राज्य इसमें कोई जिम्मेवारी लेने के लिए तैयार नहीं था या कोई विभाग भी जिम्मेवारी लेने के लिए तैयार नहीं था क्योंकि कई विभाग इसमें इन्वॉल्व हो जाते हैं इसलिए ये स्टैंडिंग कमेटी का व्यू था कि इसको एक्सटर्नल अफेयर मिनिस्ट्री को इसको अपने अंडर में करके और इसका लॉ बनाना चाहिए और स्ट्रिंजेंट लॉ बनाना चाहिए इसलिए इसकी आवश्यकता महसूस की गई
जी हम एक संघीय ढांचा में काम करते हैं स्टेट की अपनी जिम्मेदारी होती है और अपने अलग अलग राज्यों की अपनी जिम्मेदारियाँ होती है और समिति ने ये कहा है कि एक सुप्रीम कोर्ट चीफ जस्टिस को एक कोर्ट को एलोकेट करना चाहिए इस मैटर्स को एडजुडिकेट करने के लिए आप इस बात से कितनी हद तक सहमति रखते हैं
मैं इस बात से सहमत हूँ क्योंकि इस पर काफ़ी डेलिब्रेशंस काफ़ी लंबे चौड़े हुए और लोगों ने अपने अपने विचार व्यक्त किए क्योंकि अब पहले तो सारे स्टेट जो हैं वो कोस्टल एरिया पर नहीं है उस जो कोस्टल में है उसमें कुछ बड़े स्टेट हैं कुछ छोटे स्टेट हैं इसलिए अब तो कोई ऐसा संघीय ढांचा होना चाहिए और अगर संघीय ढांचा बनेगा तो मैं सोचता हूँ कि अगर सुप्रीम कोर्ट की कोर्ट उसको डायरेक्शन दे तो ज़्यादा कारगर होगा कि गवर्नमेंट अपने स्तर से करे
ओके इसमें जो पायरेट्स आते हैं और उनका अगर वो आके यहाँ कोई भी हमारे फिशरमैन को या कोई भी हमारे मछुआरे को मार के चले जाते हैं ये बिल में ये प्रावधान है उसको डेथ पेनल्टी दिए जाए इस पर आपका क्या राय है
नहीं मैं तो चाहता हूँ कि डेथ पेनल्टी देना चाहिए क्योंकि आखिर हत्या में भी आप रेयरेस्ट ऑफ द रेयर केसेस जो होते हैं उसमें आप डेथ पेनल्टी देते हैं तो आप मान लीजिए कि इटालियन के ही जहाज़ ने हमारे दो बेकसूर लोगों को नाविकों को जो फिशरमैन थे उनको हत्या कर दी आफ्टर इट इज़ अ किलिंग इसलिए अगर डेथ पेनल्टी रहती है तो जो लोग अपने आप को ताकतवर देश समझते हैं वो चाहते हैं कि जो भी हम करके चले जाएं कोई हमसे पूछने वाला नहीं है तो हमारे लॉ में अगर ये प्रोविज़न होगा तो ये स्ट्रिंजेंट प्रोविज़न जो है ये इस तरह की घटनाओं को रोकेगा
और मेरा आखिरी सवाल है सर कोस्टल गार्ड डिफेंस मिनिस्ट्री डील करती है उसके ऊपर वाला जो है इंडियन नेवी डील करती है और जो पुलिसिंग एक्टिविटीज़ है एक बार अगर कोई इंट्रूडर पकड़ा गया वो फिर स्टेट के मामले में आता है इस तरह की कॉम्प्लिकेटेड सिचुएशन में पायरेसी जैसा इतना बड़ा सा क्राइम को कैसे कंट्रोल किया जाए
देखिए आखिर सबका आपस में कोऑर्डिनेशन होना चाहिए क्योंकि आखिर आप पायलट्स को अगर पकड़ते हैं या उनको वो अरेस्ट करते हैं तो कहीं ना कहीं उनको जमा करना होगा जाकर अगर कोस्टल के अंडर में आता है तो कोस्टल सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट के अंदर में है डिफेंस विभाग के अंडर में है मैं सोचता हूँ कि सब विभागों में कोऑर्डिनेशन होना चाहिए क्योंकि ये नेशनल इशू है और इस पर कोई सेक्टेरियन व्यू नहीं होना चाहिए
थैंक यू फॉर वॉचिंग स्टैंडिंग कमेटी वील बी बैक विद अ न्यू इशू एंड अ न्यू एपिसोड कीप वॉचिंग राज्यसभा टीवी